Alright, to make sure I get a move on with this easy time, I'll switch it back to normal once I feel more comfortable with the game mechanics, but for the moment, for expediency's sake, let's do this. Plus, frankly, you know, throwing my head against the game on normal has been an ordeal. I want to make sure I can continue moving forward to enjoy the game, so for now I'll have to go to easy. Welcome to being mentally impaired. I have extremely severe ADHD, and I'm on the autism spectrum, and that makes it difficult to play video games at the level most neurotypicals seem to be able to, so, you know, sometimes I have to do this. I love games, though, so, you know, there's a reason I want to make a living out of playing them slash developing them. But that second part will come later. Anywho. Hold on. That would be a no, because I've got my party now.
Can't you get it? Oh, shit.
The room's also...
Also, it'll really help if I just freaking dodged. Like, at all. Let's do it.
You should avoid wasting energy on our attacks. Let's read the enemy's movements and respond in kind.
Take this!
Wait, I'm gonna make sure really quick that I'm recording, because I don't know. Not 100% certain. Yes, good, okay.
Come! Take this!
What is with this thing? I don't know.
Fire.
Whatever that thing is. It's horrible.
What the hell's up with this room, too?
Must be hidden somewhere within the cell. I'm not exactly fit to search for it now. Focus on the enemy first.
Take this!
Yeah, for the moment, I'll keep it on easy. I'll get really sucked into the game because I'm progressing faster and getting to more of this meaty story that I'm, like, really intrigued about right now. So yeah, sometimes easy is what you need, and being not ashamed of that, just continuing to be a gamer and not doing it isn't fun.
I'll take care of that.
Here we go.
The enemy raised their attack power. Do not want to get hit right now.
Yeah, I need to stop fully charged thing. As cute as it is when she says that, I need to stop spamming triangles. Yeah, I'm enjoying myself a lot more. Since I put it on easy. Sometimes it's just what you need.
I believe you've seen why Alex
rode so far to wipe the records of her time.
There we go. Just do that once and then getting her combos off. It's important. Drive spinner. And follow up after square, triangle. Cool. And I need to try that again. Like. Okay, so that's how the follow-ups do. That's how you get follow-ups done.
I'll take care of that one. Lost the reading. Where to go?
Oh, whoops.
Teleport?
Oh yeah, this is a lot better. Morgana still died, so I think I'm well within my rights until I get a lot more of a handle on these mechanics, too.
I'll get you back.
Katana.
In fact, let's just kind of take this home by trying now going ahead.
Super got in a
follow-up attack!
Not like I was doing at the beginning.
It's over!
Will this be enough for me? Same. When I start really getting like grasp of things and feel like things are too easy, then I will sort of back up.
Hang on. Something's up.
Yeah, I cutscene. This is why. This is why I went ahead and went easy. I'm trying to justify it, because part of me still feels guilty about turning it down on a YouTube video to easy. Like that as a gamer and someone who's played games in their life at 26 years old, I shouldn't have to do this. But,
what?
You know, pride is nonsensical, okay? My brain can't do that all the time. Like a lot of people seem to be able to, so, you know, oh well. Interesting.
Okay.
That chain has to be really symbolic, too. Not sure of what, but maybe
that's
I'll have
strong.
A chance
this new
we
skill
keep going.
Me.
Honestly, I don't feel like I paid now. Enough attention to that cutscene because I was busy analyzing my own brain, but that's also another
what was that rumbling?
Little quirk of mine that I think is a good thing more than anything.
The birdcage in the jail is now unlocked. We will be able to access it.
For real?
It appears our most recent target held the key.
In other words, we defeated the warden guarding the key.
Indeed.
The warden and Alice's memories. A key to the cage in her jail. So a different shadow held the key, not Alice's?
Very interesting.
What are you going on about?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking how many differences there are from the palaces. Good point. The palaces don't have any rooms like these. Or wardens guarding keys in hidden locations.
It's as if the more we learn, the messier the situation gets.
Indeed, that does seem to be what's happening.
If it weren't for Sophie, we wouldn't have even made it here.
Yee, Sophie hug.
Have I been helpful to the Phantom Thieves?
Heck yee, you have.
Mm-hmm, you know it.
Yeah, onset.
Face accepted.
Daw, cute! Oh my god! Ah! Sophie's a bean!
Well, praise you all you want later. Got a birdcage to bust open.
True. We have one last task in the real world first.
Let's send Alice the calling card and take back those desires.
Okay, all that's left is send in the calling card. What should it say?
We're after the desires that Alice is seizing from the people whose hearts she changed, right? Then don't we have to write something like, "We shall take back the desires you've seized!"
Smart. Using the same logic that works on treasures is probably our best shot.
Once the desire takes form, we can steal it. If we return the victims their own desires,
everyone should return to normal.
So, what'll happen to Alice then?
Well, she should be having a change of heart and confessing soon after.
Actually, that's not set in stone.
What we're stealing this time are the desires that Alice seized from others. This isn't her own desire or ambition. Or like the treasure we found in palaces. There's no way of knowing whether or not Alice's heart will be changed.
Even if we rescue her victims, without a change of heart in Alice, this will just turn into a pointless cycle.
But if the calling card works, her desire will manifest inside the birdcage. That creates a high probability that we'll encounter Alice's shadow there.
We did cause quite a scene destroying the lock.
Whether through words or fists, don't we still have the opportunity to change her heart via her shadow?
Then let's do it! Let's take her head on!
I think Odd has all the right to be the gung-ho one here after, well, you know, going through her emotional turmoil of, this woman was an inspiration to me, how could she do this horrible stuff, kind of a thing, you know, so,
Oh, sorry.
On hug.
I know that's the dangerous approach, but if you guys are all up for it, I want to rescue Alice too. Not just her victims. Alice said she wanted to be a ray of light that could inspire people suffering through life.
Yeah.
You mean when she was on TV? I don't know if she really meant all that.
Well, I do. I get why she said it. Because of all the bullying in her past. I mean, doesn't it seem like we saw part of Alice's trauma in the secret room?
Yep. Hurt people, like I've been saying.
Trauma? It's like an invisible wound in a person's heart. It comes from living through painful experiences.
Yeah, Haru would know all about that. Because now she's familyless at this point. At least, you know, her birth family. I think her mom... I'm not sure... I'm pretty sure her mother was never in the picture as far as... I don't remember what happened to her mother, if that was ever addressed, but as far as I know, her father in Persona 5 was the only parent that she had, and then he died, so...
A wound in a heart.
Maybe that trauma's the whole reason the jail formed.
Trauma distorted Alice's heart, giving birth to the jail. That is very similar to Palace Generation. I've gotta say, it's possible.
But how is that trauma relevant to Alice's current behavior?
This is just a hunch, but I think...
Stealing someone's dude right in front of her as revenge to Alice?
Okay.
That's pretty sick.
Wait, hold on. Log. I'm missing some key stuff here. I was wondering about this too. It's just a hunch. I think she sees what she's doing as some kind of revenge against the kinds of girls who treated her badly. Yeah. Well. I sort of was thinking that. That makes sense. Now it makes more sense than what I was thinking, because, like, I didn't really have the why. I had the... She's probably doing some sort of revenge thing. It's just I don't know exactly what was behind that, but this makes a lot of sense.
But her shadow's operation is way too massive for that to be all. She just has too many victims already.
What if she simply kept escalating because no one was there to stop her? Becoming a monarch must create an awful amount of distortion.
All that only makes me want to help Alice more. If her heart's grown that distorted, then I want her to at least remember how it feels being a ray of light for somebody.
Uh-huh.
Is she beyond helping at this point? I don't know.
Well, either way on, we're gonna try our best. That's all you can do sometimes.
But there has to be someone who at least tries.
Yep.
We can't just abandon Alice.
Yep, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, Lady On.
On's awesome. She's really grown since Kamoshida and the events of P5. Which makes a lot of sense considering, well, she was one of the first people that joined us in P5 and went through most of the hardships that happened in P5, you know? The base game, or the original Persona 5, you know what I mean, kids? Now, I remember, I wonder how she's going to respond to this, because there's a dialogue option in Persona 5 that, regarding Shiho, that, you know, where you can say you're so kind, On, and she basically says no, I was being selfish, basically, as far as I remember, she says something like that. So, but how does she respond to this now?
Don't speak too soon. I'm really gonna lay into her for all this.
Yeah.
I'm with you.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
She's still kind, though, because she'd not be able to do this if she wasn't. I give credit where it's due, you know what I mean? Because I think that that's just right.
No objections here, either. However, should we engage her in combat, we must avoid taking her life at all costs.
Absolutely. That's out of the question.
Best case scenario? Just talk her out of it.
Guys, do you think I could write the calling card this time? There's something I need to tell her personally.
I believe you are. It's all yours.
Thanks. It'll be great.
Duh.
Writing a calling card? Need any help?
Ooh, you can help me with the phrasing, Sophia.
Ah! I love how everyone's really embracing Sophia. She's being so helpful, and I love the dynamic with her. I love the party dynamic anyway, and I feel like Sophia, they wrote her very well to really gel with everyone. I love it.
Awesome! All we gotta figure out now is the delivery.
I may have a plan for that. This is a special reunion of the Phantom Thieves. We gotta do this right.
Heck me. I love how Futaba often has these plans that we don't know any details about until she executes them, and then it's, of course, awesome because she's awesome. I love that. Is there anything you forgot to do? Make sure you get everything wrapped up by tonight. Once you send the calling card, there's no backing out. Muns? Do we have muns to throw around? We now have 10,000.
Who is it for? Which one?
Nope, we still have the max protectors. Okay, we can't buy medicine either. I didn't use it anyway, though, so that's good. Do you have anything to sell? No, we don't have any materials or whatever they call them in this game. Because materials are just treasure, right? Or do we need those for something? Like crafting or something? Either way, I don't think that's a feature yet, if that is a thing. I just wonder why they seem to... I think they call them materials. The treasure-like things in this game. Well, considering I'm on easy anyway, let's just go ahead and send the card and see what happens.
Here!
Oh, you all set? Then I gotta start getting ready too. Our mission begins tomorrow night. Right, let's do this. That night.
In other news, Akira Konoe,
I just fucking realized.
Announced a joint
Hold
project.
On. Okay, good. I am still recording. I was paranoid that I wasn't. My usual recording method is different this time because I needed to jump into it and not have set up this morning. Just to make sure I got some recording out of the way for the weekend. But anyway. No.
One-time rival company, Pineapple. Tech heads are fired up with anticipation at the news. Awaiting
Pineapple, Apple. Ah, nice. Alice is really always on point with these parody company names.
Good evening.
Aha! Another one of these. Yep.
Perhaps you remember us.
We are the Phantom Thieves.
And we're back in action with a new heart in our sights.
A wicked witch who treats people like toys. Alice Hiragi.
You pretend you're a ray of light, but all you do is hurt people to indulge your own darkness. You're a bad person, and bad people have to be stopped.
And all those desires you stole.
Tonight, we're taking them all back.
Beautiful. Except, I really don't know if he should have shown his face, but eh.
Okay, next I'm scheduled at... Oh, it's the manager. Hello?
Oh, this is bad, Miss Alice. Look at the email I forwarded you.
What in the... Phantom Thieves? You're taking my desire? All the desires I've collected?
No, you can't! I need those! That's what makes me the monarch!
I need those to... Without those, I'll...
All right. I'll wait for you. I don't want toys that don't do as they're told. I'll smash you for certain this time.
You've said that like 3 times already. Oy. Turn of the Futaba Cannon. I love the Futaba Cannon. That was a blast. Heck ye. Shibuya's in Phantom Thieves. I love the way that they brought this back, because it was a huge climactic moment in the original game. I love that. Shibuya's in Phantom Thieves frenzy all over again. I'm sure Alice got her calling card by
come
now,
on,
too.
Come on!
So, all that's left is to wrap this up. Let's head in and finish the job we started.
Let's do this.
Excuse me for the burpage, friends.
Let's go.
Alright, tonight we take back the stolen desires. God damn, Makoto's figure is really well defined in that shirt and jacket and pants combo. Anyway, sorry. Makoto's hot. God damn it. Anyway. Alright, explore!
Everyone, time to change Alice's heart.
Let's go.
Man, it's times like these, I know I'm supposed to be fit.
I know, man, I get that Felio's wheel. And it's the hype music as well.
Sound good?
So much Dergy nostalgia at this point. Heck, yeah. Aha, interesting.
Perhaps it fell when we opened the lock.
Interesting.
Climbing this should give us a straight shot to the birdcage of desires.
Aha. Neat, so it gives you a shortcut right to it. That's very nice. I'm guessing that's probably going to be how they're all designed.
Whoa, that's...
I love the moon in the background in this big thing.
That's enormous! Why is it so big?
At least it actually materialized for us. Thank goodness.
Oh, that is a relief. I was worried our standard palace procedures wouldn't work.
Thankfully, they will.
All right, Skull. Get to hot.
No. Look at the size of that thing.
What do we do now? How do you steal something like that?
I admit, I don't know either.
Well, we're gonna have to figure that out after we beat
it's
her.
Hot.
Hello.
It's her! Alice.
So, it's a fight after all.
I'm not gonna sit here and pretend that I don't find that... whatever you would call what she's wearing sexy. Especially, like... you know... just the way it frames her midsection and her thighs, because I enjoy those a lot. Anyway.
Oh dear. You thought.
Yes, a behind shot. Oh, like oh, nice ass. I'm sorry. Listen, it's the game. I really love the stockings too. Sorry. Just look, they're overtly sexualizing this character. Okay, leave me alone. But let's be honest, even if they weren't, I would, because my brain is my brain, and it's a video game character. And I'll dial it down if enough people complain about it, but I'm just... look, my brain's horny, okay?
And what exactly do you plan on doing with those desires? Hey, you! Joker, right? Did you come back to me so you could be mine?
I also really actually enjoy that, heart pendant on her, the nape of her neck. I'm not sure exactly what you would call that part of her body specifically, and the choker as well that it's attached to, and the fact that it's strapped down and, you know, interesting. I don't know, the design's just cool, basically. And fittingly BDSM-ish for her. By the way, the portraits in this game are immaculate. I love her portrait, just the way it looks and how badass she looks there. And hot, of course. We're here for your desires, bitch.
Oh, so you really are here to steal it.
Alice Hiragi! We know all about the horrible things you've done.
You seized people's desires by force and turned them into your puppets.
You toyed with people's emotions and made them mistreat one another.
You even opened up stores so you could bilk all the people you brainwashed.
We can no longer overlook the wicked changes of heart you forced on the people.
The phantom thieves are about to beat the distortion out of you.
The Kamaki-san,
You're so beautiful. There's no way you could understand. You have no clue what I've been through.
You mean what happened to you at Shujin?
Where did... How?
We know all of it. How you were bullied. How it was torture for you. But I still...
Oh, okay. You found out. No matter how much I hide it, the past still comes back to me. How pathetic. What a mess. That doesn't matter now. With this power, I can have everything. Everything I've always wanted. Mine.
Ooh. I love this guitar riff and this epic build-up. I love these strings. Oh, this is a cool sight. Oh my Jesus. Ooh, I love this song. Oh, interesting. Okay. Okay, yeah. I should have been expecting to see some weird BDSM stuff in the boss. But yeah. I think the bosses are all supposed to be creepy and weird. And... Like a visual manifestation of the person's worst desires. And I think that's why all the bosses in Persona 5 look so fucking weird and ugly.
So this really is Alice in Wonderland.
Oh my! I'm
yeah,
a very important
that's,
date.
That's a good way to say it.
Come along, come along! I have such wonders to show you!
What wonders?
Ignore her, Sophie. She just wants to torture us.
Yeah! I love Sophie's naivety and how it's played here. It's kind of cute, frankly. And it makes sense. She's an AI. She doesn't really know about human stuff. I mean, well... Ooh, I really love this scene so far. By the way, well, in my particular headcanon, Joker's dating Makoto because I love her. So I'm wondering if if that really... I mean, I know it's not addressed in any direct way, but, you know. And see, I wonder, you know, Onset, how would that be any of your business? And I wonder if, like, you know what I want to take that as? Her dating Ryuji, almost. Because I know that people ship them, and I do too now, frankly, after replaying stuff in my Royal playthrough that I'm doing right now. And a lot of, Their childhood friend teasing, you know? Especially in the On to Ryuji. I'm gonna play On this entire time. She deserves it. I've decided that now. In fact, I wonder if, just like in Persona 5, every one of these bosses is going to be personally tied to someone. I really do wonder in the party. And I just realized, first boss, you know, relation to On, Kamoshida, Alice. Will it go in the same order? I guess we'll see.
Are you here to take everything I have? Just like she did? Just try me.
Well, I really love this song. A lot.
Whoa, holy shit!
Why is she so fast?
It's time to take you all to school!
Thanks!
This is to get up.
By the way, what's she weak to anyway? Yeah, okay, yeah, fire, perfect. So, yeah. Ouch. I love this. By the way, I enjoy this shot for no particular reason whatsoever. I'm gonna keep it here on the screen for no reason at all. No, I'm sorry. Listen, I like nice asses, alright?
I remember the real answer. You have to remember too, Alice. Tell me, what do you really want?
Did we do it?
I think it's fitting that we defeated her the moment that she started to falter like that. And I find it interesting that even during the boss fight, we start to get to her.
I'd like to try it out next time.
That's never how the bosses in Persona 5 worked from what I really remember, anyway. I really like how there's a constant dialogue when we're fighting, too.
How can I still not be strong enough?
Now, granted, I didn't really actually end up hearing a lot of that because I was busy fighting. That's the kind of downside to that, but I really do enjoy that dialogue, what I heard of it, of course. And I hope that one day I am able to comprehend it all just because I'm used to playing the game now and then I replay it, you know.
Why can't I change?
Oof.
I'm not the victim anymore!
Oof.
Enough, Alice. If you keep going, you'll just make yourself feel even worse.
That's the thing. Yeah, see, why can't I change him, not the victim? She wants to never feel like a victim again. And having power over others makes it clear that hey, she's not the victim, because she's the one victimizing. It makes a lot of sense. Also, thanks for the camera angle, Atlas. It's very appreciated. Anyway. Panther really gets you, for a good few reasons.
I just can't compare to someone like you, Takamaki-san.
Huh.
All my life, I'm no match for the real winners.
Ugh.
I tried so hard to change, but I was still made fun of, still bullied. I just wanted to stop being miserable. I poured my heart into fashion and worked to get so far. But then, she showed up again. Started running her mouth about my past. She told everyone what a pathetic little shit I was.
Oof.
That's why I took all of it from her. Her boyfriend, her social circle, everything. And that still wasn't enough for me. It wasn't just her.
Everyone it started with her. It makes a lot of sense.
All the people who just stood there when I was kidding. I'll destroy every single one of them.
Wait, so... Was she raped or just beaten? Oh yeah, wait, hold on. I think this does go into like while she was climbing, you know, the ladder of fashion, she might have been abused, like sexually or something like that.
Alice, so this is a wound in a heart.
This power lets me get revenge. So I.
You became the bully, right?
You. Idiot! What good does that do? Now you're just as bad as the people who made you suffer.
Yeah, and see, An would really, really understand that because she almost killed Kamoshida. I want you to to sort of realize, but that would have made her as bad as him, so she didn't do it.
Is that how you want to live? Like one of those bullies? Didn't you want to be something else? A ray of light for others. And for yourself.
Oof, Ming.
Don't give up because of those selfish bastards!
Takamaki-san. You're right. I wanted to rescue them. All the people like me. Going through the same thing.
And see, that's what I want to do. I hope that these videos help people like me that have been through things similar than I have. You know, my perspectives and the fact that I'm open and honest about the struggles I've been through on these videos. I really hope they help people.
But
it's not too late to change.
You
in the way that you actually need to.
So? Takamaki-san, I want to apologize to the people I hurt and start over.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you can turn it around. I've been through a lot of the same things, but thanks to my best friend and the Phantom Thieves, I was able to stand up for myself and do the right thing.
She's talking about Shiho here, and of course us.
You're never alone. Once you're back to your real self, let's be friends, okay?
Aww.
You wanna be... Really?
Uh-huh.
Oh my god.
I totally love Alice. We even share the same dream.
Thank you.
Duh.
I'll go back now. Where I belong. This time, I'm gonna be...
I love that.
Oh, this is bad! It's coming down!
And see, this way... It doesn't seem like her life's gonna be ruined, like, frankly, all the people we changed in Persona 5 itself. Which is good. Well, I mean, definitely once this all comes out, but... Alright. It gets destroyed. Interesting. And the treasures it's okay, so all the treasures collect and then combine into that big thing. And then once the shadow's destroyed, it all splits back into the desires, and the desires return to the people that had them stolen from them. Ah, look at Sophie being cute! Oh my god! I love her! I love that shot. I'm gonna use that as the thumbnail. That's too perfect.
That was effing amazing!
I know, right?
Did we just witness the desires returning to their rightful owners?
You got it, Yusuke.
Yeah, that's what it looked like to me. Everyone who got a desire disappeared afterward.
Is anyone else, like, mesmerized by just watching Sophie's spinning ponytail for some reason? Whee!
I hope that means their real-life counterparts are returning to normal.
Only one way to find out.
Yes, you're right.
Wait, what the...
What is it, Mona-chan?
Something's wrong. It's not collapsing.
But the giant desire blew up! Like...
No. Just look around.
Now that you mention it...
Whenever we stole a treasure, we'd have to leave the metaverse entirely, right?
Yeah, we always had to haul ass out of there.
That is most assuredly not happening now. If anything, it's grown eerily quiet.
So, if the Monarch is toppled, and the desires are all returned, the jail still doesn't collapse?
It would appear that palaces are different from this jail, after all.
There's a chance we haven't actually resolved the issue yet.
I wonder how Alice will react to this.
Could we find out when we get back to the real world?
It'd be nice if she could recall what happened here, but no one shares memories with their shadows.
Think she might talk to Panther?
Huh? Yeah, yeah. You two could really hit it off.
She did say that she loves her.
Yeah.
Cute.
I mean, it was worth going that far for her to come to her senses. Alice really is a one-of-a-kind talent, and her dream is definitely something worth fighting for. I just hope she can remember how that dream first made her feel, so she can bring that feeling to the people who need it.
Well said.
I don't know if there's anything I can do to help her, but I at least want to be there for her.
Fascinating.
What's up, Sophie?
Just as the Phantom Thieves predicted, Alice Hiragi appeared to change her logic. This would not be possible had we simply defeated her. How did you predict the outcome?
We didn't really predict it. Being able to change is what makes someone human.
Someone is human because they can change. The human heart is much more complicated than expected, isn't it? Just when you think you've grown beyond your pain, the smallest thing can bring you all the way back down again.
Indeed.
The human heart is indeed difficult to comprehend. It's filled with mysteries.
But the opposite can occur. Just when you think that there's nothing left, something awesome can bring you back. Or you can be like me, where I feel like I've adjusted to the point where no matter what happens in my life, I am able to always return back to what I love and what I want to do with my life and the things that I enjoy and the intention that I want, you know, the positive intentions that I have for what I'm working on and other people and, you know, etc.
Well, you're pretty high up there on the mystery charts yourself, Sophie, my dear.
Oh my god. Yeah, that's true. I love the way she said Sophie, my dear. Oh my god. I love you, Futaba. I love all these damn characters. Thank you, Atlas, for making this game.
No, I'm...
Ed 5 itself.
Sophie, humanity's companion, right? We get it.
You got it, Skull.
Not bad, Skull.
Do you really get it?
I love all of these. Like, I don't remember if there was much of that in...
Well, what do you say we head back now? I'd like to check on the real world, Alice.
I don't remember if there was much of that in the original Persona 5. These, like, parts where everyone's, you know, talking and laughing at once together like you would in real life. It feels very, very, very human, and I really like... There's some really good feats of voice acting and stuff in this game for the fact that it was recorded in everyone's closets during COVID-19, you know? Very, very impressive.
Yeah, let's get going.
Especially all the together voice acting like that, that I just mentioned. That must have been really tough to coordinate that way, you know? Like, from, you know, everyone being remote like that. And I think they nailed it. Maybe back to LeBlanc.
Hey!
By the way, that is a mood right there. Just kind of chilling in your bed, phone in your hand behind your head. Covers half on you and a kitty cat next to you. I love doing that, damn it. I love just chilling in my bed like that. I'm sure most peeps can relate.
Han was very angry with Shadow Alice earlier. By the end, though, she appeared happy. Why is that? Wasn't she angry at Alice?
They understood each other.
Okay. Anger is not just for hurting people.
Indeed. Anger can be used as a motivation to do something better. It's just... You know... It's all about figuring out how to channel your anger in the right ways. And I think I'm better at doing that, too. It feels really good.
It is also able to save people.
Indeed. It depends. But yeah.
Consider. Anger saved Alice. If someone is in the wrong, anger can be used to show them the error of their ways.
Absolutely.
The human heart is such a mystery. But thanks to you, I've gained valuable experience. Thank you.
Duh.
I hope to learn more from you.
Duh. You have to save your current progress. Ha! Yee! I really enjoy that, especially the moments that On got to shine again.